Good morning. This is Dr. Ankita. Today I'm going to present a paper based on the study comparison between conventional radiograph and HRCT in interstitial lung diseases. Introduction. Interstitial lung diseases are a diverse group of diseases which affect lung interstitium and share similar clinical radiological manifestations. They are heterogeneous group of disorders of lower respiratory tract that are characterized by both acute and chronic inflammation. Generally, it is an irreversible and relentless process of fibrosis in the interstitium and alveolar walls. Interstitium is the tissue of alveolar wall between capillary endothelium and alveolar epithelium and is the site of primary injury. It is characterized by anatomical distortion of peripheral airways and interstitium determined by alveolitis followed by a stage of fibrosis. In the diagnosis of ILDs, clinical, radiological, and histological correlation is a must on most occasions. Chest X-ray remains a basic tool of investigations in most of the occasions, but HRCT of chest became an invaluable tool in the diagnostic process. HRCT is more sensitive and specific than chest radiograph in the diagnosis of ILDs. Aims and objectives: to correlate findings of conventional X-ray and HRCT in ILDs, to evaluate if HRCT can detect pulmonary abnormalities in patients with suspected ILDs but with normal X-ray, to study different patterns of lung involvement evident in both X-ray and HRCT. Methods and material. Source of data: 30 patients referred to the Department of Radio Diagnosis with the suspicions of ILD. They were subjected to both X-ray and HRCT. Diagnosis was made on clinical and radiological findings. Material: Siemens Helios 500D microampere X-ray machine and Siemens 16 slice computer tomography are used. Methods: HRCT scans were performed in supine position in 16 slice Siemens CT machine in suspended inspiration. The matrix used was 512x512. The window was set at 1200 to 1500 and the window level at -600 to -700. Patients underwent X-ray in posterior anterior view at 60 kilo voltage and 5 to 8 milliampere per second. Discussion. The principal causes of ILDs are fibrosing alveolitis, inhalational disorders, drug-induced disorders, interstitial pneumonia, hypersensitivity pneumonitis, connective tissue disorders, and collagen vascular disorders. Patterns detected on HRCT and X-ray are airspace consolidation, linear and septal thickening, reticulonodular opacities, ground glass opacities, increased lung attenuation, mosaic attenuation, any cystic lesions, honeycombing pattern. Observation. The main observation in our study is that higher number of samples with findings are detected on HRCT than compared with X-ray. Even if both methods could detect abnormalities, HRCT could characterize the abnormality and specify its location more accurately. In our study, 2 out of 30 patients have completely normal X-ray, but abnormal findings are seen on HRCT. The inference we draw from this study is that HRCT is much more sensitive and specific than X-ray in assessment and diagnosis of ILDs. This is a chart showing the comparative findings in X-ray and HRCT. For example, only 2 patients are identified on X-ray with reticular opacities, while 6 patients were identified on HRCT. Only 5 patients with ground glass opacities were identified on X-ray, while 12 patients were identified on HRCT. In my study, 60% of the patients were male population and 40% were female population. These are the results for the detection of reticular opacities. Only 73% could be identified on X-ray, while 90% of patients could be identified on HRCT. For nodular opacities, only 37% could be identified on X-ray, while 63% were identified on HRCT. These are the images showing X-ray and HRCT of reticulonodular opacities. The results for the detection of septal thickening are 20% could be identified on X-ray, while 50% could be identified on HRCT. For honeycombing pattern, only 20% could be identified on X-ray, while 30% patients were identified on HRCT. Traction bronchiectasis, only 30% could be identified on X-ray, while 40% were identified on HRCT. This slide shows subpleural traction bronchiectasis on X-ray and HRCT. Consolidation, 43% were identified on X-ray and HRCT. This slide shows the upper lobe consolidation on right side. Ground glass opacities, only 33% were identified on X-ray, while 43% could be identified on HRCT. Lymphadenopathy, only 33% were identified on X-ray, while 53% could be identified on HRCT. Summary. Interstitial lung diseases are a diverse group of over 200 disease entities in which the primary site of injury is lung interstitium. These diseases vary widely in their etiology, clinico-radiological presentation, histopathology, and clinical course. The study is conducted in the Department of Radiodiagnosis, KIMS, on a set of 30% patients with the sex distribution of 60% males and 40% females. All patients were subjected to both X-ray and HRCT. The images were acquired, viewed, compared, and analyzed. However, many patients with known ILD history may have normal chest X-ray. Therefore, giving these patients the benefit of HRCT in detecting the abnormalities is important. Conclusion. HRCT therefore seems to be the investigation of choice in evaluating patients with interstitial lung diseases. These are my references. Thank you.